Hello, and welcome back to Clinically Speaking. Today I'm here with an update on COVID-19 regarding the pediatric population, as well as news about booster shots and a promising new medication. The number of COVID-19 cases in our pediatric population is rising. Consider that altogether, from the onset of the pandemic to the end of September 2021, more than 5.7 million children under the age of 18 tested positive for COVID-19, or 16% of our total U.S. cases. However, children now comprise 22% of the active cases. Some good news is that it appears severe illness resulting from COVID-19 is uncommon among children, and hospitalization is extremely rare at less than 0.2% of cases. Yet, there is still a lot we do not know about the longer-term physical, emotional, and psychological effects of the virus. The medical community will continue to track these effects. Even better news is that Pfizer has formally requested emergency use authorization for its vaccine for children ages 5 to 11, and an FDA committee is meeting to review it at the end of this month. Children in this age group would require two doses administered at least 21 days apart, each containing about one-third of the adult dose. With Moderna actively in trials, we expect them to announce recommendation for use of their vaccine in children as well. In Pfizer's pediatric trials, their vaccine demonstrated a robust neutralizing antibody response to prevent serious disease with no increased occurrence of side effects beyond what we've observed in young adult populations. Federal regulators have approved expanding trials for the Moderna and Pfizer shot for the purpose of identifying rarer side effects. Pfizer is also studying the efficacy and side effects of its vaccine in children ages 6 months to 5 years. We expect those results to be available later this year. And importantly, based on findings from research into the vaccine's effectiveness in protecting the newborn and the unborn, experts recommend and encourage COVID-19 vaccination for women who are pregnant or breastfeeding. Mothers can provide immunity not only for themselves, but also for the tiniest of lives. Studies have shown that COVID antibodies are passed through the placenta in pregnant women and through breast milk in nursing mothers. This is critical, as only 31% of pregnant women in the U.S. have been vaccinated, and cases of COVID-19 in symptomatic pregnant women have a higher risk of admission into the intensive care unit and a 70% increased risk of death. We continue to see a lot in the news about vaccine boosters for vaccinated adults. The nation's top health officials recommend a third dose of the Pfizer vaccine at least 6 months after the second shot of the initial vaccine series, at this time only for specific populations: adults ages 65 and older, individuals ages 18 to 64 who are immunocompromised because of their higher risk for severe infections of COVID-19, and individuals at higher risk of exposure due to their occupation, including healthcare workers, airline employees, and teachers, among others. Recently, Johnson & Johnson requested FDA approval for their COVID-19 booster, and we anticipate that Moderna will soon announce their recommendation for boosters. As we've seen, information continues to evolve daily. I encourage everyone to watch for CDC updates regarding when you and your family members might be eligible for COVID-19 vaccines and boosters. Lastly, as you may have heard, on October 1st, Merck announced that its new pill to treat COVID-19 reduced the risk of hospitalization and death by about 50% in clinical trials. Merck plans to seek FDA emergency authorization for the antiviral drug known as molnupiravir. The pill is designed to be taken as soon as possible after a person shows symptoms when the virus is replicating rapidly and the immune system has not yet mounted a defense. The FDA could authorize the medication for use as early as the end of this year. We will continue to follow guidance from the nation's top health officials regarding availability and prescribing. Thanks for joining today. We'll be back in the coming weeks with more Clinically Speaking. Be sure to sign up for weekly news, insights, and updates at evernorth.com. Until next time, make it your choice to be healthy, be safe, and be well-informed every day.